So yes, beta, we are doing this chapter, The Summer of the Beautiful White Horse. And we are supposed to read from page 3 onwards. Fine, by the time everybody joins, let me give you the gist again. And a new student has also joined us. So we welcome Aditi in our class. I hope you will be a sincere student, as rest of the students are also quite studious in this section. Fine. So I welcome you and just keep learning. So characters are Aram, Murad, and Uncle Khosro. By the time we'll be able to know more characters are there, but later on I'll introduce you. So Aram and Murad. Aram is a 9-year-old boy. They have not mentioned the exact age of Murad, but he is elder than Aram. Fine. So both are Armenian boys. They belong to Armenia and they speak Armenian language. And they have an uncle Khosro, who is also quite crazy, who is considered one of the craziest person in the family because he's very casual about everything. He never takes anything seriously. So everybody thinks so that Murad has considered that craziness he has inherited from Uncle Khosro, because rest of the people, rest of the family members are not that eccentric. Eccentric means person with strange behavior. Clear? So Uncle Khosro is quite eccentric person. And Murad is also a bit of crazy. And Aram is a very sincere child. Fine. So this is the basic introduction of characters. Main thing is the background is in Armenia and they speak Armenian language. And in Armenia, they have different tribes. Fine. And they belong to Gargolian tribe. All of them, they belong to Gargolian tribe. And their tribe is known for honesty and truthfulness since 11 centuries. So nobody in their family ever cheated. Clear? So they are known for honesty and truthfulness since 11th century. So you can very well imagine that their tribe is very proud of this achievement, that nobody in their family or tribe has ever stolen anything or even hurt anyone or did something wrong. Fine. So they are known for their honesty and truthfulness. So in this family, Murad has taken birth, who's quite different from others, who believes in living life to the fullest, even at the cost of stealing also. So he has, you know, the chapter starts when Murad taps at the window of Aram's room. Aram was still sleeping because it was 4 o'clock in the morning. So when Aram opens the window, he could not believe his eyes what he saw. He started rubbing in disbelief. He saw that his cousin Murad, he was sitting on a beautiful white horse, which can never be his because they belong to a very poor tribe. They cannot even imagine of purchasing or buying such a beautiful horse. So Aram directly asked Murad that, where did you steal it from? So rather than giving answer to him, Murad says, let's go. Join me for horse riding. So Aram is a true lover of horses. He loves, you can say he breathes horses. So he's so much into horses. That was his dream, to ride on a horse. So by seeing a beautiful horse in front of him, he gives a wrong explanation to himself. He says, okay, this is not a stealing. We are not stealing the money, or we are not going to sell the horse off. If my cousin Murad has stolen the horse, and after riding, we will give it back to the owner. So I should also join. So Aram also joins his cousin Murad. Fine. Yahan tak humne padha hai, and then we have started the introduction of Uncle Khosro. Page number 3. I'll be sharing the screen with you all. Fine. You can open your books also if you don't have books. Only then you need screen. It's not working. System has stopped. Are you able to listen to me? Whenever I share the screen here, some problem comes. Okay, late instructions are coming. Wait, let me share again. Fine. Is it visible? Fine. From here onwards. Clear? I have highlighted it. Page number 3. Every family has a crazy streak in it somewhere, and my cousin Murad was considered the natural descendant of the crazy streak in our tribe. So we are going to read that how Murad was considered crazy because there was a person in their family named Uncle Khosrow who was quite crazy enough. Before him was our Uncle Khosrow, an enormous man with a powerful head of black hair and the largest mustache in the San Joaquin Valley. So there in Armenia, he was considered one of the enormous, means very big. Clear? Huge structure he was having, I must say. Fine. And with a powerful head of black hair and largest mustache in the San Joaquin Valley. He was very furious in temper. Furious means angry. So irritable, so impatient that he stopped anyone from talking by roaring. It is no harm, pay no attention to it. Underline this dialogue. This is the, these are the pet words of Uncle Khosrow, and there is a question also on this same words. This is the thing he keeps on saying. It is no harm, pay no attention to it. So, har cheez mein wo casual attitude show karte hai. Koi bhi gravity of situation ho, kitni bhi serious problem ho jaye, wo yehi bolta hai, it is no harm, pay no attention to it. So man is so furious in temper, so angry, easily provocable, easily irritable, you can say. And this is the character sketch of uncle also. Fine, the whole paragraph. That was all. No matter what anybody happened to be talking about, once it was his own son, Eric. So this is one incident, beta. With this incident, we'll get to know ki kaisa hai Uncle Khosrow. Uncle Khosrow has one son. His name was Arak, A-R-A-K. He and Arak was running and panting, and he came 8 blocks to the barber's shop where his father was having his mustache trimmed to tell him their house was on fire. So what happened? One day, Uncle Khosrow, he went to got his mustache trimmed at a barber's shop. Fine. You know that he was having the largest mustache. So usko maintain karna padta tha. So he went to barber's shop, and when he was getting his mustache trimmed, what happened over there? A boy, his own son, Arab, he came running, covering 8 blocks. And while he was running badly and madly, he reached his father and informed his father that, father, our house is on fire. Ki humare ghar mein aag lag gayi hai. Let's go. What does he say? This man, Khosrow, sat up in chair and roared. They are not using the word spoke. Kyunki wo baat nahi karta tha, wo chillata hi tha bas. He roared in his higher pitch. It is no harm. Pay no attention to it. That shows that how casual he was. Apne ghar mein aag lagi hai. Aur wo keh raha hai, pay no attention to it. Clear? The barber said. Barber ko loga, isko samajh mein nahi aaya. Barber kehta hai, the boy says, your house is on fire. Tumhare ghar pe. So, Khosrow roared. Enough. It is no harm, I say. Kehta, fir kya ho gaya? That shows his casual attitude. Clear? That he was a crazy person who never behaved in a normal way. Clear? Yes, Diya, clear? Fine. My cousin Murad was considered the natural descendant of this man. So now why this incident was brought out to light? Kyun bataya hume unhone? So that we can compare that if Uncle Khosrow is like this, what about this boy, Murad, clear? Who is also a person with strange behavior. So my cousin Murad was considered the natural descendant of this man. So people started saying in the family ki Murad to apne uncle Khosrow jaisa hi. Although Murad's father was Zurab, who was practical and nothing else. That's how it was in our tribe. So who was the father of Uncle Khosrow? Zurab. He was not like Uncle Khosrow, but he was very practical persona. A man could be the father of his son's flesh, but that did not mean that he was also the father of his spirit. What does it mean? You can biologically inherit the body of your father. You can look like your father, but it is not a written thing that you will be inheriting the qualities of your father or traits of your father also. So So Uncle Khusro was not like his father, Zorab. Fine. Similarly, Murad was also not like his father, but he was like his uncle Khusro. Clear? The distribution of the various kinds of spirit of our tribe had been from the beginning capricious and vagrant. So now they are telling that different sort of people were associated, capricious and vagrant. Some people are very energetic, some people are very clever. So these people are very eccentric. Fine, I'm using this word again because this is the word we use for. Hum unko pagal nahi bol sakte hain. Aise logon ko. You cannot, you know, kai baar hum aise logon ko milte hain. We meet some people, you cannot even judge that this person is eccentric. They look very normal, very, you know, they'll be talking normally. But in their families, when they are into their families, those who are living with them 24/7, unko pata rehta hai ki what is the trigger to this person. Triggers hote hain logon ke. Fine, ki aapne kuch bol diya, they will start shouting at you and you will realize ki why I have not said anything wrong. But there are some trigger, everybody has some triggering point, I guess. But some people are very balanced persona. So these people are considered eccentric people. Person with strange behavior, they're not mad. Clear? Hum unko biologically pagal nahi bol sakte hain. So they are strange, fine, wacky. We let the horse run as long as it felt like running. So now again coming back to the present, kya tha? Murad and Aram both are riding the horse. Murad has stolen the horse. He invited his cousin Aram. Aram got carried away and he joined his cousin. Clear? So we are on next page. Clear? You can see in the picture that how Murad was riding the horse. At last, my cousin Murad said, get down. I want to ride alone. So finally, I told you, Murad is like that only. Isko jo karna hai, wahi karna hai. He's saying, get down now. Bahut hua, now you get down. I will be riding the horse alone. Will you let me ride alone? I asked. Ab Aram is also getting greediness of riding the horse. Yeah, I should also. That is up to the horse, my cousin said. Get down. Kehta, tumhe kya pata? Can you ride? That is up to the horse. Will he allow you or not? The horse will let me ride, I said. So Aram is the Aina, he is telling you the story. So Aram said, horse will allow me. Mujhe chance to do, I want to ride it. We shall see, he said. Don't forget that I have a way with the horse. Now, underline this dialogue, very important. I have a way with a horse. What does it mean? That I know how to handle horses. Jaise ab aapko you remember that Uncle Khosrow have a pet dialogue. It is no harm. Pay no attention to it. Similarly, this boy Murad, he has a pet dialogue. I have a way with the dash. Kisi bhi animal ka naam fit kar do wahan pe. Theek hai, kabhi wo kehta hai, I have a way with the horses. Fir aage unko injured bird milega ek. He kahega, I have a way with birds. I have a way with farmers. Theek hai, wo kisi bhi means Murad is just like Uncle Khosrow. He believes that I can handle any situation. So he's overconfident here. That he says that I know how to manage horses. I know how to handle birds. I know how to handle people. This is what he wants to say. Clear? So that shows his arrogance level. I got down. Aram had no choice. Aram had to got down as per his elder cousin's advice. My order, you can say. My cousin Murad kicked his heels into the horse and shouted, Wazir, run. So this is a way of saying, ki, let's run fast. The horse stood on its hind legs. Hind legs are the back legs of the horse. It snorted that sound of the horse and burst into a fury of speed that was the loveliest thing I had ever seen. My cousin Murad raised the horse across a field of dry grass to an irrigation ditch, crossed the ditch on the horse, and 5 minutes later returned dripping wet. The sun was coming up. Now it's my turn to ride, I said. My cousin Murad got off the horse. Ride, he said. So when within 5 minutes, Murad was able to ride the horse proficiently. Now you give me the answer. Do you think riding a horse is very easy? Can you do it in first attempt? No. No, but it's a skill. Horse riding is a skill which needs to be acquired. And how can we acquire any skill? Yes? With practice, yes, sahaj is right. Any skill, आपको कुछ कैसियो सीखना है, स्विमिंग सीखना है, हॉर्स राइडिंग सीखना है, इट्स अ स्किल ओनली. यू नीड टू प्रैक्टिस हार्डर. सो नाउ विद दिस, व्हाट डू यू डिटेक्ट? डू यू थिंक दैट ही इज राइडिंग द हॉर्स फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम? इट मीन्स ही हैज बीन राइडिंग द हॉर्स अर्लियर. इट मीन्स ही हैज बीन, ही हैड ऑलरेडी स्टोलन द हॉर्स सिंस पास्ट मेनी डेज. How many days or how many months, we don't know. Let's read. So he was so proficient in riding the horse that his cousin, you know, forgot even ki, wow, my cousin Murad is riding the horse beautifully. I should also, usne socha, main bhi kar lunga. I will also give it a try. Fine, as if it is very easy. So let's move to next page. My cousin Murad, he got off the horse and he gave, okay, ride. Very easily, he said. I leaped to the back of the horse and for a moment knew the most awful fear imaginable. The horse did not move. When Aram sat on the horse did not move because horse is not acquainted with its owner now, Aram. Usko nahi pata Aram ka. Animals are very smart, you know, they are able to perceive. If you keep on talking to them on daily basis, you keep on caressing them, touching them, loving them, talking to them, and then riding on them, they will let you do it. Fine, they all animals, I must say, they will never harm you unless and until you seem to be, you know, a threat to them. You might have seen dogs running after the cars for no reason. Dekha sadkon pe koi bhi car nikalti, dog runs after them. Not all, but few. Why? Because they might have, I witnessed one or the other accidents are done by cars. Many animals, many dogs and puppies, their young ones, they, you know, a car ran over them and they die. तो डॉग्स क्या परसीव करते हैं कि दीज पीपल हु आर ड्राइविंग द कार्स दे आर द मर्डरर्स ऑफ अवर यंग वंस. सो व्हेन एनी कार पासेस बाय दे रन एंड बार्क फॉर नो रीजन. बट सिमिलरली इवन अ स्ट्रे डॉग कैन बी योर फ्रेंड. आप अपने घर के देख लेना, आप उनको रोज खाना डालो, फाइन, स्टार्ट फीडिंग देम एंड दे विल बिकम योर फ्रेंड फॉर नो रीजन. दे विल नेवर बाइट यू. But don't give it a try. You know, okay, ab jao and your parents start saying, ma'am ne idea diya tha. I'm just saying it varies. But most of the animals are very, you know, loving. They understand the human language with their body behavior. Ki haan, ye mujhe nuksaan nahi pahunchayega. Fine. I have, you know, 3-4 cats at our home. They come from, they just, you know, arrive from nowhere. We offer them milk and sometimes breads and crumbs and whatever. After eating, they disappear. But they know that on this time, daily basis, they come and drink. Fine. So this, and never say anything to us because they know that they are feeding us. So this is the language of animals. They understand the language of love only and care. That horse did not move at all when Aram said, because he did not know who Aram is. Fine. So he, now Murad will be giving instructions to Aram that how to ride a horse. The horse didn't move. Kick into his muscles, my cousin Murad said. What are you waiting for? We have got to take him back before everybody in the world is up and about. Clear hua? Early morning mein wo kyun ride kar raha tha? Day time pe usko chupa deta tha. Subah 4 se 5 usko jana leke. And when the sun is rising and daylight is there and everybody will be returning to their work, farms mein farmers will be returning, anybody can see that they are riding a horse. Anybody can ask, okay, ye to Gargolian family se hai. And they cannot, you know, buy a horse. They are too poor. And they cannot steal also. They are very honest. So there will be a question mark. So he's very smart. So Murad is just asking him to do it immediately because sun is rising. I kicked into the muscles of the horse. Once again, it reared and snorted. So this is the way animal is practiced. Fine. So then it began to run. I didn't know what to do. Instead of running across the field to the irrigation ditch, the horse ran down the road to the vineyard of Dikran Halabilian, and where it began to leap over vines. The horse leaped over 7 vines before I fell. Then it continued running. That was a failure for Aram. Aram thought, my cousin is saying, kick into the muscles and horse will run and it will be very nice ride. But it was not. He gave wrong instructions maybe, and horse was not compatible with the owner. So it kept on running and running. Even Aram fell off the horse and it kept on running. So he was not able to write it because it was his first day of writing. My cousin Murad came running down the road. I'm not worried about you, he shouted. We have got to get that horse. See, Murad is not worried that whether my cousin has got any injury or not. Kehta, I don't bother. That's why he was considered eccentric. You go this way and I'll go this way. If you come upon him, be kindly, I'll be near. Kehta, idhar se jao, I'll be coming from this way. Catch the horse anyhow. We have to, you know, give that, hide that horse. I continued down the road and my cousin Murad went across the field toward the irrigation ditch. It took him half an hour to find the horse and bring him back. You know, because it got mad only, it kept on running. So half an hour efforts and he got the horse back. All right, he said, jump on. The whole world is awake now. What will we do? I said. Well, he said, we'll either take him back or hide him until tomorrow morning. He didn't sound worried and I knew he would hide him and not take him back. Not for a while at any rate. So, you know, Aram knows his cousin very well. Usko pata hai, ye wapis nahi karega horse ko. Definitely, he will be hiding it the way he does it on daily basis. And he was not worried even. Ye bolte hue, Aram was scared, but Murad was not at all scared. Kyunki jo aap habitual ho chuka hai is cheez ka, wo kaise darega? Where will we hide him? I said. So Aram asked again one more question. Where will we hide them? Hide him. I know a place, he said. How long ago did you steal this horse? Ab Aram ko samajh mein aa gaya that he's hiding the horse and since many days. And he's asking how long. It suddenly dawned on me that he had been taking these early morning rides for some time and had come for me this morning only because he knew how much I longed to ride. So now he was able to understand that my cousin had been riding the horse since many days. और आज जब इसको proficiency हो गई है horse riding की, now he's coming to me and asking me to ride. Anyhow, I said, how long ago did you begin riding every morning? Again, Aram asked. And Murad is not giving any answer to him. What does it show? Not until this morning, he said. Are you telling the truth? Kehta bas aaj subah, not until this morning. Are you serious? Of course not, he said. But if we are found out, that's what you are to say. See, kitna smart hai wo. Kehta aaj yehi bol, agar pakde gaye to yehi bolna. That we got this horse today morning only. Clear? I don't want both of us to be liars. All you know is that we started riding this morning. Kehta bas itna yaad rakho, Aram. If we are caught up, you will say we got this horse today morning only. All right, I said. He walked the horse quietly to the barn of a deserted vineyard, which at one time had been the pride of a farmer named Fetwagian. There were some oats and dried alfalfa in the barn. We began walking home. So, ek farm tha jahan pe oats aur alfalfa ugaya jata tha. He found a place and finally he kept the horse over there. So, is it clear to all of you, beta, children sitting at home? Shall I continue? Or any doubt is there? Fine. So not until this morning, they decided ki if they will be caught up, they will say ki this morning only they got this horse. We began walking home after tying the horse at Fetwagian. Underline kalo, ek question hai again. That where they used to tie the horse in a deserted, ye pura paragraph, barn of a deserted vineyard, which at one time had been the pride of a farmer named Fetwagian. There were some oats and dry alfalfa in the barn. So there they used to tie the horse. It wasn't easy, he said, to get the horse to behave so nicely. Ab bata raha hai apne cousin ko. So Murad is telling it is very difficult to train a horse. Animals are trained. Human beings are educated. Now you know the difference. Training is to let, you know, to teach a particular animal or bird to do a particular task. That is called a training. Human beings ko bhi training milti hai. Okay? But they are educated also. They can impose their more knowledge into it. Animals utna hi karenge jitna sikhaya gaya. Usse upar nahi jayenge. That is called training. Fine? So he was trained. He's saying that it takes time. See, I have trained this horse. We began walking home. It wasn't easy, he said, to get the horse to behave so nicely. At first, it wanted to run wild. But as I have told you, I have a way with the horse. See, self-praise. Apni tarif kar raha hu. I can get it to want to do anything I want it to do. Horses understand me. How do you do it? I said. Kaise kiya? I have an understanding with the horse, he said. Yes, but what sort of an understanding? Aram asked. A simple and honest one, he said. Well, I said, I wish I knew how to reach an understanding like that with a horse. So Aram wished that if he is able to get that understanding. You're a small boy. When you get to be 13, you will know how to do it. Underline, this is the age of Murad now. In the beginning, we got to know that Aram was 9-year-old boy. And now we got to know that Murad is 13-year-old boy. He's a teenager, early teen, you can say. I went home and ate a hearty breakfast. It was morning time. I was so happy that day. Aram was also happy. At least he saw the beautiful horse and tried to ride on it. So he ate breakfast. And that afternoon, my uncle Khosrow came to our house for coffee and cigarettes. He sat in the parlor. Parlor, beta, is that area where the people sit and eat. Sipping and smoking and remembering the old country. So that day, by chance, that Uncle Khosrow visited their house and he was there sitting, drinking coffee, smoking cigarettes, and their one entry is going to be made. New character, beta. The name of that character is John Byro. I won't be reading further. I'll be telling you about John Byro now. Fine. So next character is John Byro. Who that John Byro is, let me tell you. John Byro, beta, he's a farmer by profession. And let me disclose the secret. He's the owner of the horse. Whose horse Murad has stolen. And he is in search of his horse. And he wants to find it eagerly. You know, people over there, they were not into, you know, they were not having vehicles and all. The main vehicle, the main means of transportation was animals only at that time. So that farmer was walking many miles to reach his destination. And he was, you know, so tired because he lost his horse. And he has come to talk to Uncle Khosrow over there. He didn't know. John Byro doesn't know that these two Armenian boys, or especially that Murad, is responsible for this theft. But by chance, he just wanted to see John. John Byro wanted to meet Uncle Khosrow. And he wanted to inform him that he's not able to find his horse. Boys are just, they have, after riding on the horse, they have come back. And when they will see that, when they will bump into John Byro, bumping into someone means accidentally, by chance, meeting someone. Fine, I bumped into you that day. Means you don't know that you're going to meet that person. In that way, we say bumping into. Clear? So, what happened? That afternoon, when Uncle Khosrow was having cigarettes and coffee, another visitor, John Byro, arrived over there. So, he was an Azerinian. He's not Armenian. Tribes are na pe. Armenia se hai wo. He's Azerinian. Variation of slang will be there, variation of language will be there. Out of loneliness, he had learned to speak Armenian. So John Byro was Azerinian, but he has learned their language, Armenia also, Armenian language. Because he felt loneliness, he wanted to talk to someone, so usne dusri language bhi seekhi. So it's again, beta, period is over, so we'll continue tomorrow.